Okay. The young man was assisted by a group of other survivors, all armed but really friendly. He found a girl, threw her a weapon and fought off the bandits guarding the exit. Siblings were happy to be reunited, but also very confused. Turns out the bandit leader is actually their father. It's a crazy small world we live in. Anyway, they were really thankful and promised to contact us again soon. We are glad to see Dolores come back safely from the wasteland. Timmy is good. Well, at least he was 5 minutes ago. If there was anything to report about Dolores, this is where it would have been written. And Ted has rested. Ah. You're all gonna get water, but we're kind of running out of soup. We're not certain about the situation on the surface. A trip could be risky, but we could really use the supplies. So, the only one who could go out is Ted. Aha. So, let's prepare and see if we can send him out. A loud crash, a surprise shriek, and a bit of debris falling from our ceiling. Truly a recipe for a good start to the day. As it turns out, Sherikov found a new toy. A bit of innocuous wiring that it ripped out of the wall. Who knows what the cable's for, but our lights are still on, so it can't be that important, right? Should we take the wire away from our fluffy friend and investigate it? That might be a good idea. Boy. We grabbed the cable and followed it to a rusty old truck parked in our neighbor's driveway. Upon opening the door, we were confronted with two men wearing huge headphones who looked extremely surprised to see us. They wiretapped our shelter when we were asleep, and they were listening to everything we said. We gave them hell and marched back to our bunker. No news is good news. There's nothing new going on with Timmy. Dolores is quite calm given the situation. Ed is not complaining today, at least not very much. Okay. Well, Ted should be ready to head out, actually. Let's get you something to drink. He's not getting anything. We need to make a choice for today's expedition. Which one of us is best fit to face the wind? Right, that's gonna be Ted. And what are we gonna give him? You're gonna get the map. Yep. We have almost made it to 30 days, guys. Nothing new to report on Timmy. Dolores is pretty fatigued. Ted left for the surface. We hope he'll be back soon. And he brought a map. Okay, so she looks fatigued. Okay, let's give them both something to eat and drink. Go. The agents who were spying on us are now at the door and want to explain themselves. Should we hear them out? Okay, let's hear what they have to say. There might be something else they're up to. I can still hear someone knocking. They were agents, real, live, secret agents on a government mission. We saw their identity cards, briefly. They weren't listening in on us, it was the cat they were interested in. They made a request too, wanting us to aid them with some of their top secret missions in the future. If we do that, they promised they will extract us to a government safe house full of supplies and donuts. Hopefully they come back soon with more information. No news is good news. There's nothing new going on with Timmy. Today was relatively calm for Dolores. And everybody is interested in that cat. What's that sound? A galloping horse? We rushed to the door and were greeted by two men, dressed like they'd come from a medieval fair. We identified the source of the sound. One of them was holding two rocks and hitting them against each other constantly, while the other was skipping and pretending to be a rider. They said they're looking for some antique cup, but they'd got lost and they would be most grateful if we would let them check our map, provided we have one. Well, of course we don't have that anymore. Mind some of these stories. Oh, she doesn't look very well. Wow, look at that. Okay, let's see. We couldn't contain our laughter and our guests took offense. They ran off shouting that our ancestors were rodents and smelled like forest fruits. How rude. Looks like Sherikov snuck out to hunt out in the wasteland last night. This morning we found a dead glowing rat on our doorstep. Sherikov seemed pleased with his gift for us and quickly expressed its disappointment when we threw it far away from our home. Nothing good will probably come from touching dead radioactive rodents, though, so maybe we should have just left it where we found it. Timmy is pretty fatigued. Timmy has rested. Dolores came down with a sickness. Oh boy, not good. There we go, let's heal. Everybody get some drink. This is terrible, we can't sleep. We've been having problems with sleeping ever since we got down here, but now it's worse than ever. If we don't deal with this problem, we won't be able to cope with any other challenges that await us outside these thin shelter doors. Okay. Day 30. Well, she looks like she's healthy again. So that's good. Bravely ignoring our symptoms, we try to get at least an hour or two of sleep. No luck. We are even more tired than we were, and there are other problems we'll need to face soon. Let's just hope our yawning will be enough to scare raiders away or save us from radiation sickness. Timmy is really tired. Dolores was cured from her illness. Okay. It's so easy to escalate silly arguments and close quarters doesn't help. We were chatting and then suddenly we were fighting and fighting. Let's just hope we'll get over this soon. Oh, that's the radio. Oh, we used up our first aid supplies. We could barely sleep after all that arguing. Let's hope this won't happen again. Timmy seems okay, as much as he can be in our current situation. If there's anything to report about Dolores, this is where it would have been hidden. Okay, time to ration supplies. Okay, today you're getting food. We were able to catch the military broadcast again. This time they're asking us to get out with a flashlight and signal to their plane after it gets dark. If all goes well, they'll be able to find us. Sounds like we'll be leaving soon. Yeah, bummer, our flashlight doesn't work anymore. No, so we can't do that. If we had matches, we could have built a fire or something. The signal has to wait. Besides, do they even know how much flashlight batteries cost? Especially in this economy. Especially after it was wiped out. Timmy is good. Well, at least it was 5 minutes ago. Today's been fine for Dolores thus far. Okay, get a little bit to drink today. Timmy got back to the shelter from his expedition and looked fine, but it turned out he had hurt his hand on a piece of rusty metal and the wound was infected. It doesn't look like it's healing up. We have to patch it. Oh. Okay, we're gonna cut his hand off. I'm sorry, guys. Oh boy. Timmy was very brave about the idea of cleaning up his wound with a heated axe blade. Ah, okay, we're not cutting his hand off, we're just heating it up. This is much better. It was a bit painful, but it was soon over. The axe is in no shape to be used again, but Timmy seems much better. Ted has safely returned from his voyage to the surface, and he brought a map. We believe that our expedition to the wasteland must have been followed by strangers. We should be more cautious next time. The local school is a big building a mile away from our house. Nobody liked that place. The atomic blast didn't change that. Now, without windows and a few walls remaining, it looks even more unpleasant. Pleasant or not, it seemed like a good spot to hunt for some useful supplies. Everybody adored that lunch lady. She was almost 80 and everything. She touched tasted great and smelled of tomato. Now we know her secret, tomato soup cans. The biology class had an aquarium. The fish had died since no one fed them, but the aquarium water could still be drinkable. There was enough for a few bottles. I'm not sure it would be very drinkable if there had been dead fish in it, but okay. The PE teacher was a World War II veteran. He kept some of his war trophies and memorabilia in his office at school. This included grenades, a bazooka, and a fully functional gas mask. Okay, the local scout team had its own room in the school basement. We found it filled with boxes and boxes of scout handbooks. Maybe they were preparing for the apocalypse. Anyway, we just took one. Okay, so now we have a scout book and we have our gas mask. Like the good scout he is, Timmy is making the best out of it, this situation. He even seems cheerful. Life is hard for all of us right now, but Dolores is in a good mood today. We hope it'll stay this way. Ted looks very weak. If he doesn't eat today, it might end really badly. Ted is pretty fatigued. Ted is really tired. Okay, well, let's get Ted something to eat and drink. Using a high-tech setup involving paper cups and yards of string, the agents rang in with our next top secret mission that will surely land us in the VIP bunker very soon. They want us to go on one successful expedition, write down what we saw in the journal. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, right? Okay, we're gonna send Dolores out. We graciously agreed to fulfill their request. They thanked us for doing our civic duty and promised that they would be back with more information soon. Despite the dire circumstances and all the trouble we're going through, Timmy is being very brave. Dolores is on her way to the surface. Let's hope she'll make it back safe and sound. Ted is hungry. Okay, let's get Ted something to eat. Let's get them both some water. The siblings are back. Their group is growing bigger with each passing day, as they pick up tired and hungry survivors and nurse them back to health. However, so far they only have one tent and soon they'll run out of space for everybody. Right now, they're scouting the town looking for a good spot to build a bigger camp and could really use a map. Oh, I forgot to give them the map. But on the other hand, why are they not giving us a chance to be with them? If they are nursing everybody back to health, right? They might be friendly, but is it really worth it? We only have one map and it's way too precious to us. They'll have to find their own. Timmy seems okay, as much as he can be in our current situation. Ted's stomach is rumbling. Okay, Ted is still hungry. We were never huge fans of mushrooms, but with a colony of them growing on one of the walls, we've changed our loyalties. We're all about mushrooms now. Should we eat them? Oh yeah, let's try and eat them. That might have been a bad decision. Yeah, Ted doesn't look very, very, very healthy right now. We learned something today. Tomato soup is our best friend and mushrooms aren't. Yuck. That recon mission was risky business. We had to visit neighborhoods that were dicey even in the best of times. The area was full of mutated cats and dogs fighting each other in gangs, all of them armed to the teeth. We barely made it out of there alive, but the agents seemed to appreciate our efforts. Let's hope these missions are actually worth it. Our bucket is just about due for an upgrade, and we are expecting the government shelter to have an excellent bathroom, maybe even a hot tub. Timmy seems okay, as much as he can be in our current situation. Dolores was hurt. Ted's stomach is rumbling. Ted became infected with something. Oh boy. Do we have two of these? Only we don't have. Oh right, we don't have any. Oh, that's not good. And I think he was the one who was hungry. The state of the wasteland remains unknown to us. Maybe we should risk it and go out. After all, you only live once. Well, everybody is either too weak or too exhausted, and sending Timmy out of the question. So, no preparation. It's not easy to be calm in these situations. Hopefully, we'll keep our peace or else. We might need to act like wolves. Survival of the fittest and all. Oh no, what now? Okay, we're still all here. We're trying our best to remain calm. The situation we're in is far from normal and we might never get used to it. We hope the help comes soon. Despite the dire circumstances and all the trouble we're going through, Timmy is being very brave. Dolores is doing quite well, or she just can't find anything to complain about today. Something should be done about Ted's sickness. Yeah, that's a little hard. There we go. And we can't send anyone. It seems awfully quiet outside. Maybe it's safe, maybe it's not. Yeah, but no one can go out, so... We should really see about attending to Lois's wounds. It's not going away on its own. But we have no healing items. And unfortunately, we can't send Timmy out, even though he's the only one who seems to be relatively healthy. Poor, poor Dolores. We're not optimistic. Timmy should eat something. We're no doctors, but we should help Dolores. Her wounds are pretty bad. Ted is fine. Oh, so Ted is fine now. Well, I don't know. Timmy was hungry. I don't want to waste any more of Dolores because I think we're gonna lose her. Are we gonna be hardcore like that, guys? I think we have to be hardcore like that. Yep, not getting anything. We're not certain about the situation on the surface. Okay, well, we still can't send anyone. We saw something strange on our way back from the expedition. A chain of lights on the horizon, pulsing and flashing in a chaotic manner. It didn't make much sense to us at the time, but when we discussed it in the shelter, Timmy said it might be a secret scout signal. He would need to check out the signal by himself and decode it using a scout book. At least we have that. A little funny they went on an expedition, though I can't send them on an... But, okay. Okay, let's see what he found out. We haven't seen Timmy this excited in a long time. He decoded the flashing lights as a scout signal indeed, which means some of his friends are still around and kicking. Unless a few bandits found a scout book laying around and they're now trying to lure innocent kids into a trap. Timmy wants to prepare a coded message and try to transmit it soon. Timmy has rested, Dolores got ill. There's nothing going on with Ted, nothing new anyway. Okay. Nope. No one gets it. Ooh, Timmy has a chance to get back. How big a chance though? Yep, well, we're gonna try and send him. We're running out of supplies. We've always wanted to throw a party with a huge cake. For some reason it never worked. One time we were promised a great cake and it turned out it was a lie. That was a disappointment, we weren't glad. We're definitely getting a cake when the radioactive clouds are gone. Oh boy. Maybe moving away won't be too bad. We can probably make new friends, meet new people. Provided anyone is still alive, that is. Timmy doesn't need much, but he should drink. Lois can't remain this thirsty for long. All Ted wishes for are a few drops of water. Yeah, but she doesn't really look very good. Okay, you two are getting some water. And that's it. This is a good day to go outside. Stretch a bit, get some fresh toxic air. Maybe scavenge a thing or two. We could use some extra supplies, that's if we want to survive. Okay, well, we can send Timmy. What are we gonna give him? Give him a scout book. Maybe he'll find out more then. Oh, someone is knocking. Man, they're not looking very good. Timmy went out to the wasteland. We don't know what we'll do if he doesn't come back and he brought the scout book. Dolores will not survive without water any longer. Seb says there's no need to worry about him. He's okay. He doesn't look very old. Yeah. Okay, he's gonna get some food. Kind of being hardcore here. Clearly, we're trustworthy after our last successful mission, as the agents came back with another request. We are to generously provide either a couple soup cans or some water bottles for an agent in the field. They'll take care of the delivery. In return, we'll be given an encouraging pat on the back and a promise of a better future in a safe government shelter. Well, I'm not sure I would give it to them anyway, but we don't actually have anything to give them because they sound a little suspicious. We're not giving them anything, at least not this time. Dolores would really love to eat something. Dolores will not survive without water any longer. Ted is fine. Only have like one little bit of food and a little bit of water. The problem is simple. If we don't wash ourselves, we'll get sick. Seriously sick. It smells really bad down here and doesn't seem like it'll get any better over the next couple of days. How about we do something to fix it? What are they... Emo supposed to do? Yeah, let's find out. Might be the end. Oh boy, look at that. Yep. Oh man, if we only had a few drops of water, we could have avoided what happened. Dolores died of dehydration last night. Dirty or not, it's the smell that's the biggest issue here. How do we deal with that? Well, we got some spare ammo, so why not use the gunpowder to kill the smell? Let's rub it in. Sounds like a brilliant idea. Okay, Ted is really thirsty. Ted has recovered from his sickness. That's good at least. Well, we're gonna give him the last supplies we have. The cat is growling in the general direction of us and our supplies. We're not sure if cats drink soup, but it's the only thing on the menu today, and it's up to us if we want to share our tomato-y delicacy with our pet. Well, we can't do that because I gave it to him. Well, I could have gone back and taken it again, but look at that face. Oh yes, if it's hungry, it can just go outside and hunt some mutant rodents or insects. We just can't allow the cat to eat a whole can of soup. It looked angry, but there was no retaliation, not yet anyway. Cat has gone crazy. Well, we don't have anything. We can only hope Timmy is gonna come back. The twin siblings contacted us again. Today they visited our humble shelter, saying they are looking for a map of the nearby area. Their plan is to find a relatively safe place for a new camp that could accommodate the whole group and anybody else who would want to move in with them. A plan of the city would be very helpful in their situation, at least to help organize their scouting expedition. Okay, let's give them the map and hope that is going to give us a chance to come with them, maybe? Preferably when Timmy comes back, right? We don't want to leave him. Or leave the place and then not be there. We were happy to see them again. We quickly handed them our map and pointed out several locations that might be worth checking out. They left before it got dark to still get a few hours of scouting in daylight, but they said they would definitely be back again to share some news and a friendly chat. We hope they find a good place. Maybe we could visit them when the camp is ready. Ted says there's no need to worry about him. He's okay. Yeah, he won't be for long. We've discussed everything we could and no one is willing to chat anymore. The silence is really disturbing. We do something before we start talking to ourselves. That. Oh, Timmy came back. And he looks fairly healthy, actually. Ah, how fortunate we took the radio with us. We can probably listen to some music. They still play music out there, don't they? We were so afraid for Timmy, but he came back from the wasteland and is safe with us now. And he nearly brought some water and a med pack with him. Our little trip to the surface might have been spotted and followed. We should be more careful next time. Our expedition was able to get to a local hospital. It appears that the blast blew up some of the upper floors, beds, some with patients still on them, and shreds of medical equipment were lying all over the place. However, after exploring the first floor, we concluded that the majority of people inside evacuated the building in time. The canteen had a respectable supply of tomato soup. It looked like this was the only thing they fed their patients. Now we are 100% sure it's healthy. Man, that's some hospital. Okay, so we got a can of soup. There were plenty of bottles of liquid in one of the wards. Peroxide or not, water is water and beggars can't be choosers. Okay, we got two bottles. It wasn't hard to find a fully equipped first aid kit. After all, it's a hospital. Nice. One of the dead patients had an axe sticking out of his back. According to his chart, he was feeling perfectly fine before the atomic blast. We decided he probably no longer needs that axe. If it's sitting in his back, probably not. That scout handbook was really useful. Too bad we lost it during the expedition. Timmy should eat something. Timmy's really tired. Ted is really thirsty. Okay, so you're hungry. You're thirsty. We're almost certain there are bandits around. Running into them would be a big mistake. Well, none of them are ready to go out, so we're gonna take a break from that. The agent visited us in the middle of the night to remind us about their request to provide either a few soup cans or a few water bottles for their colleague in the field. If we do help them, we might get one step closer to a cozy government shelter. But we don't have enough to share. Oh boy. There we go. Perhaps we can help them another day when we feel more up for the task. Tim is very hungry. No new problems are troubling Ted this morning. Okay, you're hungry. You'll get some food. We've heard some commotion above and we're pretty sure it's a band of raiders. Venturing outside might be quite dangerous right now. Well, no one is ready to go out, so nope. Timmy prepared a short message to be transmitted tonight. There are a few options on how it could be done, so let's try to pick the best one. Or just back out completely. It's not too late to give up on this idea. Okay, let's transmit a message. We have to do something for sure, because we are running out of supplies again. Timmy went outside and climbed the highest point he could find, which in our situation turned out to be a fallen over truck with two more cars stacked on top of it. How did the cars get stacked on top of a truck, I wonder? Probably not the safest place to be, but he managed to transmit the message successfully and return safely. Now we wait. Timmy is very hungry. How about getting Timmy something to drink? He's not looking well. No new problems are troubling Ted this fine morning. Okay, let's give you something to eat and drink. They're almost certain there are bandits around. Running into them would be a big mistake. Well, we still can't send anyone out, which is a little problematic. Oh dear, we just remembered we planned on taking a trip south in 2 months. If it's still there, we're going, right? We're pretty sure they don't bomb warm places. Okay, they don't. Oh, we have company. Let's just leave all those questions be for now. Nothing new to report on Timmy. Where is water when Ted needs it? Okay, Ted needs some water. We've heard some commotion above and we're pretty sure it's a band of raiders. Venturing outside might be quite dangerous right now. We were about to go to sleep when we heard someone knocking on the door. Who could it be at this hour? Who could it be in this part of the wasteland? How in the hell did they survive the nuke? Should we open up? Well, we barely have any food or drinks left, so let's see. Day 50. Look at his face. Timmy was right. The signal did come from his scout friends. They managed to track us down thanks to the transmission. Timmy sent out a few days ago, and they came bearing gifts. Timmy was happy to reunite with his friends, if only for a day. All in all, this was a good day for us. Oh, we got a game. Despite the dire circumstances and all the trouble we're going through, Timmy is being very brave. Ted has rested. Okay, well, getting something to drink. We played a game of list the things you hate the most, and our neighbor's name kept coming up for some reason. That reminded us that the little weasel had a safe in his living room. We always wondered what's inside. Maybe now's the time to finally find out. But who will do the honors of stealing the possessions of our arch nemesis? Okay, we gotta send Timmy out to do that. I don't think we should trust Ted with anything right now. We marched to Ned's house and found a safe cracked open by the blast. Most of its contents were destroyed, but we still salvaged something out of it. Ned was nowhere to be found. He likely perished in radioactive agony. All told, it was a good day, and we got some ammo. We were so afraid for Timmy, but he came back from the wasteland and is safe with us now. Despite the dire circumstances and all the trouble we're going through, Timmy is being very brave. And Ted is hungry. Okay, you can get some food then. We're almost certain that bandits around, running into them would be a big mistake. Oh, so Ted is kind of getting healthy now, so let's see if we can do this. The agents are getting rather impatient. They visited us yet again, demanding to know whether we'll give them our supplies or not. If we ever want to see them again and get a chance of improving our housing conditions, We should consider giving them the supplies they keep asking for. But we don't have anything to give them. Sorry. See if Ted can still go out. We denied them assistance for the last time. We probably won't see them ever again. Jimmy is good. Well, at least he was 5 minutes ago. This morning has been calm enough for Ted and he's doing well. Nope, no one getting anything. This is a good day to go outside, stretch a bit, yep, and get some toxic air. We're gonna send out Ted. What are we gonna send with you? You get the gas mask. But I don't know if we're gonna survive long enough for him to come back. We can't leave Timmy without water for too long. Ted left for the surface. We hope he'll be back soon. We're gonna try and push it and see if we can survive a little longer. Every new smell attacks our noses and there's a little shelter instantly. There isn't much we can miss. So when a single brick fell out from the wall, revealing a tight opening, our senses were immediately invaded by a terrible stench. We should probably check that hole out and see what the source of that smell is. Okay, something died in the wall. Oh, that doesn't sound good. Oh, and someone is knocking. We approached the hole cautiously and peeked inside. What happened next nearly gave us a heart attack. Some crazed rodent, a reptile, or whatever this crazy mad creature was, leapt out and started jumping all over the damn shelter. It was everywhere. We couldn't catch it. Before we could do anything, it pushed our radio off the table and went back in the hole it crawled from. We never saw it again. Aww, we lost our radio. Jimmy's in terrible shape. We need to give him water. Now. Okay, well, you're gonna get some water. Our help is needed yet again. The siblings came by today to share some latest news. The good news, the camp is ready. The bad news, while building it, they overlooked a nest of mutated cockroaches nearby. They're afraid these roaches might be territorial and aggressive, so they're looking for some means to get rid of them. Cockroaches. Okay, let's give them the axe. Hope it pays off to be helpful. Oh boy. We gave the group just what they needed to get rid of the unwanted housemates. The insects are gone and their nest was destroyed. They'll need to find another camp to settle in. Hopefully they'll choose a bandit camp instead of bothering decent wastelanders like our friends. No news is good news. There's nothing new going on with Timmy. Okay, well, he got water yesterday. Some door-to-door salesman found his way to our shelter. We remember him from before the apocalypse. He came over with a bunch of leaflets and tried to convince us to join something called Astro Citizen, but we refused. Now he just wants supplies and he says he will reveal some state secrets to us in return. Yeah, right. Oh, the end! What happened? As a rule, we don't trust door-to-door salesmen, especially ones who attempt treason. We told him to go back to whatever planet he dropped to Earth from. He got angry and stormed off, mumbling something about how our souls are going to be devoured by alien Lord Yonta. Is that a Y or an X? I don't know. Poor guy, he seemed very confused. It was very unwise of Ted to walk right into the hands of a gang of filthy bandits camped nearby. He is not coming back. What happened to Timmy? Did he die from thirst? Of all places we could have perished, this is probably the best one, or maybe not. So, we spent 56 days in our shelter. All of us are okay, but not Barry Jane. Okay, then we have a little bit of family ties. We had a fire, we had Spider-Man. A quick stop at the shore. We had a visit by the nice Wolverines. The nuclear fallout has gone. Widow's Might. What was that about? I don't even remember. And fine arts. Okay. Then we had an unexpected call. We've had some unlikely survivors and benefactors. Things are just business as usual. We followed the trail and made contact with the military. Neighborhood Blues. Oh, we're talking about the neighbor, right? The cookie business. There and back again. Reunited. Fun and games. There are some references. There and back again. Okay, I think that reminds at least some of us of something. Big Brother, the nice who say, Sleepless in Atomville. Oh boy, Misty Armor Plane, Back to School, Recon, No Touching. Yep, yep, yep. Okay, then we lost the lowest that to dehydration. Beast for the Beast. Okay, Ted has gone crazy. The Grand Plan. Oh, that's the plan Timmy had, right? Silent as the Grave, and ER visited. Oh right, we went to the hospital. Is Ned safe? Okay, we denied supplies. Something smells worse than us. Oh right, we had a visit. Tear down this nest. Ted was captured, perished. Why? What happened to Timmy? Timmy was still alive. I know he was thirsty, but... Oh, we told him to go back to you. He got angry and stormed off. Okay, he was very angry, and then we lost Ted, but... Okay, I don't know what happened to Timmy. I guess he died from thirst, maybe? Because we still had him, and we still had, what, half a drink of water or something left. Okay, well, we perished, but we did survive for 56 days, guys. Wow, nice. Oh man, some of the stories. There's definitely some movie and book references in this. Okay, well, that was it for this time, guys. I think next time we're gonna try and do one of the challenges. So, thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming!